你好，我是 Amy。Today we are going to be talking about 红包。红包 is red envelope. 红 means red, 包 means bag or to wrap things around. Now, why are we talking about 红包 if Chinese New Year is already over?That's because I just wrote an article about Chinese New Year, and that is going to be published next week. If you missed the Chinese New Year because you're not aware of Chinese New Year like me, it's okay. I got you covered. I shared a video on my Facebook page that shows that entire Chinese New Year celebration in New York City. So it's a really interesting video to watch, and if you want to kind of get that Chinese New Year feel, even though it's over,You can watch that video. It should make you feel like it's Chinese New Year again. In the article I wrote, I covered a lot more things related to Chinese New Year than just 红包. But in today's video, I want to talk about 红包 specifically, especially the way how these days 红包 are given out. Traditionally, you give out 红包 on Chinese New Year to the people who are younger than you. So, for example, my parents would give me 红包, which they stopped doing for too many years. Tears.So what you do is you buy a 红包, a red envelope that's like usually in this shape, not too big, and then you have words on it or maybe lucky drawings on it, and you put money in there. Now the first thing you want to know about 红包 is you do not want to put anything that has 四, number 4 in it, because 四 sounds like the word 死, which means death or to die. So I don't think you want someone to wish you death.When they are giving you something that's supposed to be lucky, right? So, when you are giving 红包, make sure you don't give 四 in there. In any like number, 44, 444. Unless you really hate that person, then I guess it's okay. Just don't do that. Okay, now let's talk about how 红包 has changed. If you are learning Chinese Mandarin, then someone probably recommend you to download WeChat, which is 微信. 微信 is one of the most popular apps used by Chinese speakers.And one of the really awesome features that they introduced is called Red Packet or 红包. And today I want to show you how it works. To use the 红包 feature on WeChat, you can either send that to a person directly or you can send a 红包 to a group. And you have different settings that you can use. You can set the 红包 to, let's say, give it out to 20 people and then the amount can be different or random.And what you have to do if it's sent out in your group, you have to make sure you click on it as soon as possible. Else, let's say that it ran out of 20 people, then you don't get it. Today, I want to show you how it looks like when it's sent to an individual. Because I just received a 红包. Okay, it's not for Chinese New Year, but it's for something else. So this is how it looks when you receive it. When you receive that 红包,You will see something that looks like this, and if you click on it, it will open out the 红包. And I already opened out mine. You will see the person that gave you the 红包, and then how much money they gave you. I received 6.66 yuan. If you are familiar with the Western culture, you might be thinking, huh? 6.66? That is quite unlucky, right? Because those are the numbers of the devil, or monster, the energy drink, right? So...6.66 yuan is actually very lucky in Chinese culture because it means 六六大顺. So everything goes very smoothly, very lucky. I have the English version of WeChat, so if I click on me, and then click on wallet, then I'll be able to see how much money I have on my WeChat account. So as you can see, overall, I received 27.80.In RMB. To send 微信红包 to a person directly, you open out the chat with that person. And then over here, you will see a little plus icon. And if you click on that plus icon, you will notice that it says red packet. Now, mine's English version, that's why you only see the English one. But if you click on it, you'll be able to choose how much RMB you want to give to that person and also write down a little message.And you can send that 红包 to that person. So this is how 红包 has integrated into our life even without Chinese New Year. And I don't think this will replace our culture completely because we still have the traditional 红包, but it's very good and very easy to give 红包 to someone, let's say in a different country, for example. If you use WeChat, have you ever received or maybe sent a WeChat 红包?I would love to hear that. So that's all for this video. See you next Friday. Bye bye.